Hey everyone, and welcome back to Mass Effect Andromeda. On this video, we're going to be doing the assignment Sleeping Dragons. And in order to get this one, we actually need to go back on the Tempest and then come back to the Nexus. So before we do that, we're going to go visit Ryder's sister in the Cryo Bay. So down to the tram we go. Alright, and Cryo Bay.
An expedition to Eos in the Pythias system has discovered a mysterious facility that authorities are calling a vault. Though not much yet is known about the underground structure, it's believed to be remnant in origin. Noted Asari scientist, Pelisaria Basale.
What we activated in the vault drastically improved the atmosphere on Eos.
This is HNS.
Colonists will be taking you over to the Nexus. You'll need to clear immigration.
There was some kind of emergency when we arrived?
We hit an energy cloud. They're calling it the Scourge.
Wow. That doesn't sound scary.
The Nexus got it worse. As long as you avoid it, things seem to be okay.
This is not good.
I'll make it right, Dash.
Exiles.
I promise.
Okay, let's talk to Dr. Carlisle.
Harry, what's happening with Sarah?
Well, we got her out of the pod. I don't want to get your hopes up, but Sam managed to, find her, you might say.
I don't follow.
Well, she's still in a coma. But she also has an implant like yours, and Sam managed to access it. He's made contact.
That's even possible?
I wouldn't think that's even possible.
You and me both, but Sam, well, I guess supercomputers have a different view of things.
Though in a coma, Sarah's mental processes remain intact.
So, is she okay?
You can ask her yourself. A moment while I establish a link with her implant. Proceed.
Sarah? Can you hear me?
Scott? Is that you? What's happening? Where am I?
There was a problem with your stasis pod. You're in a coma on the Hyperion. Do you understand?
I think so. Am I dreaming?
Sam linked into your implant, but they say you're stable. You're safe and sound in the medbay.
This is so weird. I hear you, but I can't feel anything. Where's Dad? Is he doing okay?
Uh-oh. He's busy on a mission, or he's dead. Oh, these decisions are tough. So we can lie to her, and help her deal with the situation, but then when she comes out, she's gonna know that we lied to her, and then she's gonna have to deal with it. Or we can, take a head on now. Ooh, tough one. I think it's best to just have her start dealing with it now. So let's go with, he's dead.
I don't know how to say this, but he's dead, Sarah.
What?
It was a freak accident.
But it's Dad. He can't die.
I know. It's been hard on everyone.
I didn't get to say goodbye.
No one did.
What about finding home? Dad kept telling me how beautiful it would be.
Why do you do this to me, game? It's even better. Or it didn't work out. Well, I told her the truth about her dad, so we may as well go all truth here. It didn't work out.
There's been some complications. The Golden Worlds didn't exactly deliver.
But Dad said...
Sarah?
Am I dreaming? Where am I?
Sarah, I'm sorry.
Her pulse rate is increasing rapidly.
I need to go now.
That's enough. It's too stressful.
Sarah.
Well, I might have overdid it. Let's talk to Dr. Carlisle again.
Talking to your sister in a coma. Can't say I really bought into the whole Sam implant, but well, that was pretty amazing.
It was kind of weird. Well, it was kind of weird.
I don't know. The whole thing was strange.
I know what you mean, but everything seems weird at first. There was a time when my profession thought germs were a crazy idea. Just takes getting used to. And if it can help my patients, I'll keep an open mind.
I'm not sure why your job isn't grayed out. I've asked him that before, but let's try it again.
So you and Lexi swapped jobs?
You know that moment when you realize you're just getting too old? Right, look who I'm talking to. Trust me, it happens. For me, it was Habitat 7. Watching you guys running around, dodging lightning and the cat, it's a young man's game. Pains me to admit it, but it's passed me by. So it made sense that Lexi and I switched places. She's younger. Well, for Asari. They're still teenagers when they're 200. And she's one hell of a doctor. She'll serve the Tempest well.
I'm pretty sure that was the same, but okay. And goodbye.
That's all, Harry. Thanks.
I'll be here if you need me.
Now, when I was here before, I found an absolutely amazing bug. Alright, and the one I'm talking about is over here. Oh, he's not doing it. His head was like spinning all the way around. It was amazing. Let's see, anybody else back here? Nope. Alright. I have no idea who's talking. Screw it. Alright, we're done here. So, let's go to the docking bay. And we'll go board the Tempest. And then while I'm on the Tempest, I may as well catch up with all the crew. So, docking bay. Before we get on the ship, let's go talk to this person over here.
I don't know, maybe I should have stayed home.
What are you doing with that ship? That part doesn't
hey,
go there.
Hey, Pathfinder.
I gotta tell Cash to do something about her mechanics.
Welcome to the next Nebulous. We ask that you spend a few short minutes going through immigration processing, then we'll help you on your way.
Hi. Gil Brody is your engineer, right?
That's right.
I'm Bailey. I used to work with him in the hangars here. You wouldn't happen to know if he's available, would you?
For what?
Depends on what you mean. His duties keep him pretty busy.
No, I mean like a... Oh, never mind. Just a... Tell him I said hi, huh?
He's looking for a hookup.
If
like they spawn when I'm not looking.
Alright, I believe we're all done here. So let's get on the ship and I can check this terminal, see if there's any new news, but I doubt it. Yep, nothing there. Alright, back on the ship.
To check in with you.
Okay, and let's see what the crew's up to. We'll start with Suvi.
I saw pictures of the vault. Astounding how big it is. And how much of it didn't you see? What if it's way bigger? What's all that space for?
Could go deep in the Earth.
With what it has to do, it could go thousands of miles below the surface of the planet.
Or completely span it. An underground network. Just a thought, of course. I wouldn't even know where to start hypothesizing how it all works. The remnant builders, whoever, whatever they were, accomplished something far beyond us.
The science team on the Nexus.
I take it you work closely with the Nexus science team?
I tried to keep in contact with them. We discuss anything and everything we discover out here. After all, many brains are better than one, and Dr. Aridana is worth two or three at least. I work best when I have other people to bounce ideas off of.
Andromeda scans.
I'm still fuzzy about how we managed to see Andromeda all the way from home.
It confused me too. I mean, the light lag would have made any data 2 million years out of date. So I asked Dr. Aridana, and she told me, well, it wasn't her tech that did it. It was the Geths.
You're kidding. Those killer robots we had in the Milky Way?
Those exact ones. The Initiative obtained data from an array in deep space. A Geth construct. According to Aridana, the Geth rebuilt a mass relay and turned the approach corridor into an FTL sensor.
A what now?
It operated like a telescope, just faster than light. It provided much more up-to-date info. We don't know why the Geth were interested in observing beyond the galaxy, though. Maybe we'll never know.
Hard info to obtain.
How did the Initiative even get its hands on Geth knowledge? They're isolationist and hostile.
I don't know, Ryder. Maybe I don't want to know.
Terraforming.
What do you know about the Remnant's terraforming network?
From what I can tell, the Vault is designed to adjust almost everything about a planet. Climate, pH of the soil, atmosphere composition. There's even evidence that it can propagate life. If we can figure out how to control the vaults, we could turn these worlds into perfect habitats.
Your faith.
When did you start believing in a god?
My parents were both scientists. My home was ruled by rationality. So when I became a teenager, let's just say that while other kids found Batarian music, I found God.
But your work as a scientist...
convinced me even more, especially when I got into molecular biology, physics. The patterns I kept seeing over and over again, they were like an artist's watermarks. God, to me, is an artist. An inventor, not someone checking to see if I brush my teeth.
The Scourge.
What do you know about the Scourge?
We established that it's artificial. Someone put it there. Or they did something that caused its creation. We don't know why. That's still a mystery.
We'll talk later.
I should get back to things.
Sounds good.
Alright, do I have any new emails? Free for an interview to Ryder from Carrie Tavessa. Hello, Ryder. Word is you had a successful mission on Eos. Well done. Want to come talk about it on camera? I already did that, but we'll acknowledge it anyway. Asking for assistance, we'll do that later. Let's see. I blame you. To Ryder from Gil. You know that guy, Bailey, you ran into on the Nexus? Whatever you said to him, he decided to reach out to me, forwarding his message. Gil, I hope you are well. Our time working together on Nexus was invigorating, and I'm sure you are invigorating your colleagues on Tempest now. I envy them, and your Pathfinder. But I suppose the work you're doing now, and the pioneers you're supporting, need and probably deserve to be invigorated more than the rest of us. Snip. It drones on for 6 pages like that, before he asks me if I'd like to get a drink. I feel invigorated now, don't you? Gil. Ugh. To writer from PB, the peeved. Your doctor is one of the nosiest Asari I've ever met, and that's saying a lot. She needs to take it down 4 or 5 notches, or I won't be long for this show. Which would be too bad, I think. Oh, never mind. PB. News from EOS, to writer from August Bradley. Pathfinder, I could use your help with something Hanley's working on. I don't fully understand, so I'll let her explain it. She'll brief you when you get here. August Bradley, leader, Prodromos. And I think... yeah, I read that one before. Okay. Let's go see what Kalo's up to.
Hello, Gil. When are you cleaning up that repair on the sensor console?
I'm not. It's a redesign.
A redesign? Without a trained crew?
I'm trained and it's working great. Don't be so uptight.
Everything okay?
Oh, fine. Fine. Don't worry about it.
Well, that seemed, like it was going just fine. Alright, what else we got? This is where the loadout station is. I'll change my loadout later. And PB has relocated. Let's go figure out where she is.
Mutiny is like cancer. Left untreated, it spreads.
Keep exiling people, and you'll just run out of people.
Cut out malignant cells to give the healthy ones a chance.
Nothing's that simple, Doc, and you know it.
So we have a stowaway.
You mean PB?
She's decided to set up in one of the escape pods. You don't need a psychologist to tell you that one's got commitment issues.
Crew morale.
How do you think the crew is holding up?
I'm happy to share what I can without violating patient confidentiality. Anyone in particular? I sort them in their files and my brain by species.
Sorting method.
Why do you sort them that way?
Just easier for me to see patterns in behavior.
Human crew.
How do you think the human crew members are handling things?
There's a lot of them.
Gil.
Gil?
Gil likes to use humor as a defensive technique. He'd rather bury himself in the Nomad than tackle emotions head on.
Suvi.
Suvi okay?
Suvi's strong sense of faith keeps her grounded. I'm not spiritual, but... there's a beauty in how her mind rationalizes religion and science.
Liam.
How's Liam?
A handful. Every time I patch him up, he breaks something new. Liam's we can't lose attitude is commendable. But I worry how he'll react when something does go wrong.
Cora.
How's Cora doing?
She's processing. Your father was her mentor. She expected to follow in his footsteps. But he gave the role of Pathfinder to you. Just because she trusts his judgment doesn't mean she's not confused. Or hurt.
Non-human crew.
I'd like to check in on the non-human crew.
Ask away.
Vetra.
Tell me about Vetra.
Vetra's used to having someone depend on her. I think that's why she's so resourceful and likes providing for other people. That being said, I think she could use a little me time.
Kalo.
How's our Solarian?
He's quite the gossip. Tight-lipped about himself, though.
Drac.
Is Drac good?
That old bastard's always good. I've never met anyone who can be so stubborn and so appreciative. Could you look out for him, Ryder?
Sure thing, or he doesn't need me? Sure thing.
Don't worry, Lexi. I'll keep an eye on him.
Thank you. And maybe don't mention I asked.
PB.
Is PB all right?
She's avoiding me. Probably thinks I'll poke her with a needle if she gets too close.
To be fair, you're always giving me shots.
Not in the hallway.
Return.
Thanks for the insight.
Memory fragments.
I need to talk to you.
About something private.
Of course. That's what I'm here for.
When Dad died, he blocked off parts of Sam's memory. Things he didn't want me to see.
Or he thought you weren't ready for.
Maybe. I found this trigger. It unlocked a memory fragment of Dad on the Citadel. From when the Alliance rejected his ideas about AI, and he found out Mom's illness was terminal.
Why do you think your father chose this specific memory?
It was a turning point.
It was where his journey to Andromeda really began.
Those events started your family down a new path.
Yeah. Thanks, Lexi. Feels good to talk about this.
Friendship with Harry.
How long have you and Harry been friends?
I remember when he didn't complain about arthritis. We met at a medical convention on the Citadel. He was moderating a panel on neurosurgery in low-gravity environments. His name card was crooked, but he was so damn confident, I knew we'd be friends.
Becoming a doctor.
How did you get into medicine?
My mom was a dancer on Omega. Dad was a bouncer. I'd patch him up after busy nights, discovered I had steady hands. They put every credit they earned into my education.
Are they here in Helios?
No. Both died in a turf war. Made leaving the Milky Way behind easier.
Joining the Hyperion.
So how did an Asari doctor end up on the human arc?
Specialist in alien anatomy, remember? That includes humans. Also, Harry insisted. Maybe he always intended to switch jobs.
See you around.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Alright, well, while I'm here, let's see, can I make that helmet? What was that, Oh, and we got a codex. Let's see, probably a crew like no other. Kallo Jath. It seems that Kallo and Gil Brody don't get along. Kallo doesn't seem inclined to discuss it. And apparently there's more. What else am I missing? I'm not sure. There's still a codex, arg. Oh, it's probably under writer. Yes, the ties that bind. Let's see. You visited your sister Sarah while she was still in a coma. You were honest with your sister and told her Dad was killed on Habitat 7. You were honest with Sarah about the struggles you faced in finding home. Okay, and then what was that task? I think it's under task. Pathfinder armor crafting. Craft the Pathfinder chest piece. So do I have the materials for that? I might. Let's see. And I want armor, chest, and doesn't look like I do. No, I still need, what is that, platinum? So once I find some platinum, then I can make it. Okay, and while I'm here, let's send the strike teams out. And I'm not going to bother reading these anymore because I know there's going to be repeats and I can't remember which ones I've sent them on. So we're just going to send them on new missions, pretty standard. And I want to send them on bronze because if I try to do silver, you can see their chance of success is pretty freaking low, only 50%. So maybe soon, but I think I need to level them some more before we try the silvers. Because I don't want to send them out and have them fail, because sometimes they'll get negative traits when they fail. And that's a bad idea. So those two work. And they're out. And let's get my rewards. So just some credits. And maybe if I get really lucky, I'll get some platinum. Shelf elements. Ah, aluminum.
Strike team ready for deployment.
Okay, and I think I can also get some research data because now we have an ABP status control. And there's one reward to collect from our science pods, and we hit square to collect all rewards. And that gave me 100 Milky Way research data. Okay, let's go talk to Cora.
Report from the Nexus. Population's growing as people wake up. Lots of hopefuls waiting for a home.
Bradley will have all the help he can take.
They'll be starting crops soon. Can't tell if they have enough water or too much. I grew up on a little cargo freighter. Only saw gardens in vids. But I always loved them. I daydreamed about planting a big rose garden when we got here and still imagine it sometimes. Roses in Helios.
Let's see. We can flirt. You're a romantic.
So there's a heart soft as rose petals under that uniform.
I got plenty under here, pal. Does the big bad Pathfinder have a soft spot too?
I might. For certain someones.
Good to know. We've all got our something. I didn't for a while. After I left the Asari Commandos, well, I didn't leave. My mentor, Nasira, said I should go.
Why?
The initiative would suit you better, was all she said. Being a huntress suited me fine, but she insisted.
That was cold of her.
Wow. You fight side by side and then she gives you the brush off?
It hurt. One big kick out of the nest. Still, that's familiar. When your biotics are honed into huntress-grade weapons, people can be weird about it. The initiative seemed better. Just didn't see how I'd fit into their brave new galaxy. I never fit anywhere before. Then I met some jerk named Ryder. Talked about traveling to Andromeda like he was teaching you how to see it.
What appealed to you?
What part of that vision made you want to take the plunge?
A civilization where everyone had a place, even AI, or an overpowered human biotic. Your father said, I get being different. Now imagine being welcome and making others like you welcome too. When I was 13, I could warp a steel girder. He made me wonder, what if someone had told me that's okay?
Dad could inspire people, or nothing certain. Well, nothing was certain coming here for sure.
The whole expedition might never have launched. Dad knew that.
He wouldn't be stalled by minor issues like credits or physics. So I gave the initiative my all. Kept thinking of the niche I wanted. My rose garden. I thought I knew what I was going to be.
This is about not taking over as Pathfinder?
Didn't think it would still sting. Nasira, your father, even my parents. They leave, I'm left without answers. Nowhere to stand.
None of this is fair. Or move on, Cora. Well, it's certainly not fair, but she definitely needs to move on. So, yeah, let's just try to get her to move past this. Move on, Cora.
It sucks, but it happened. We need your mind on the mission.
Always is. But I'm human, too. Need time to find a way through. And if that remnant tech pays off, maybe someday I'll have roses, too.
Okay. Let's go this way. Eventually. Let me in. This is my ship.
Messing with that vault feels like early brain surgery. Just poking and hoping.
As long as it helps us to live here, I don't care how the vault's doing it.
Magnificently. That's how.
I prefer tech with more exposed bolts. If you can't open it, you don't own it.
Long time no chat. What's up?
The Tempest.
I hear we have you to thank for getting the Tempest space ready so quickly.
Vetra brings her impossible feats to me. I was itching to get this particular call. Capital R, ready. Don't tell her, but the truth is, I fudge reports to come in early, then bust ass in secret to make up for it. Expands the Gil legend. Plus, I convey calm and assurance, and the whole team relaxes, which helps them do their jobs better.
Friends.
What's your social circle like?
I'm good for a laugh, so I know lots of people, but I don't let too many in. My one true friend is stationed on the Nexus. She's the only piece of the Milky Way I brought with me. The more you and I get to know each other, the more you'll probably hear about her.
The Nexus.
How tough was it on the Nexus all those months?
Have you ever eaten overcooked space cow tongue?
Sure have.
Hasn't everyone?
Well, then you know. It's super tough. Wondering if you're gonna die from a critical malfunction, or maybe starvation? Imagining which would be worse? But hey, you could always take a break from the fear and boredom to dwell on being a part of the biggest failure in galactic history. Maybe even participate in a revolt.
What was your take on that?
I didn't place any bets, if that's what you're asking. Truth is, I don't think anyone made out particularly well. Whatever side you're on, you die a little when your brother, your teammate, becomes an enemy. We traveled all this way, all hope and wonder, and we end up fighting with each other over scraps. It's sad.
Our crew.
Seems like we have a good group here.
Well, Vetra and Suvi are my girls. Get along well. Lots of mutual respect. PB's a real spark plug. I like her, but she's exhausting. And Drak's my kind of guy. Brash. Takes no shit. As far as your Hyperion peeps go, Doc's kind of nosy. Liam's good for a laugh or two. Cora, she's a bit by the book for me.
I'd hate to see her off the book.
Need somebody to keep the zoo in check.
Zoo? You calling me an animal rider? Ooh, can I be a mongoose? They're like cool cobra killers. No, wait, how about a crow? Smart, irreverent, obnoxious. That's it.
I'll take your word for it. What about Callow?
He's a pilot.
Which means...
he flies the ship.
We're leaving it at that, then?
Does a Pathfinder know what to do with a dead end?
Talk to you later.
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
You again. Want to hear more about my childhood log cabin?
Your current project.
You really won't tell me what you're working on.
That's right. Next question.
The Nexus.
What was it like for you on the Nexus?
Well, I wasn't supposed to be woken up yet. A resourceful accomplice finagled my early thaw. So I kind of lived off the grid. Snuck around, bullshitted my way onto excursions off station. After I found my first remnant ruin, I started, borrowing shuttles. After that, I didn't spend much time on the Nexus. I even missed most of the revolt.
Flirting. And so far, PB is winning on my Patreon poll, so she's probably the one I'm gonna romance, but that could always change.
What does someone have to do to get you to flirt with them?
Not much at all. But I get a little extra jolt when I'm matched wink for wink. So just be yourself and the flirts will flow.
Anyone special?
You mentioned you came to Andromeda with someone?
Nothing gets by you. Guess that's why you're the Pathfinder. Just a friend. The one who woke me up early. But now she's not even that. It's better to venture into the unknown without restraints or entanglements, don't you think?
I get that, or sounds lonely. Sounds lonely.
I don't know. Don't friends and loved ones make all the effort worthwhile?
I've always been self-motivated. Don't need much more than curiosity to drive me forward.
The Tempest crew.
So how do you like the team?
Interesting bunch. I get a good feeling from Vetra, not your typical military-minded Turian. Liam seems a lively one. I expect he'll surprise me. Drak is, well, old. Wonder if he can still learn new tricks.
What about...
Gil smacks of complication. Might take some unraveling. Callow and Suvi seem busy. I hope they aren't all work, work, work. Who's left?
Well, there's...
Oh, right. Cora. What's her deal? Is she as prim and proper as she comes across?
My turn to talk?
Oh, is it my turn to talk?
Sorry. Yeah, I should work on my motor.
You might find that people reveal themselves more freely if you give them a chance. Cora included.
Really good advice.
There's also Lexi, our doctor. She's an Asari.
Oh, I'll get around to her. All in all, seems like a decent bunch.
The Remnant.
What drew you to the Remnant?
Are you kidding?
It's evidence of a sophisticated species no one knows anything about. It doesn't get more intriguing than that. There's so much to discover. I want to be the first to figure them out. And the tech, it's on a different scale. If we can appropriate it, who knows what advances we'll make.
I'll leave you to it.
You're off the hook, PB. Good luck with your project.
Thanks. Don't be a stranger.
Alright, let's go down the lift. We've got Vetra right here.
Terraforming, Atmo processors, gravity wells, life-destroying murder bubbles. We really had no idea what Helios was about, did we?
Some intel is classified.
Someone had to know. Maybe they just didn't tell us.
Did your father?
I'm not sure.
I'm just saying. I really hope you have a plan, Ryder.
Plans are useless.
Like you said, we had no idea what Helios was really like. What good's a plan?
Adapting to problems as they come up. I like that.
Good. Since you're probably gonna have front row seats to me winging it.
Looking forward to the show.
You mentioned back channels.
You talked about your back channels. What did you mean?
We brought a lot from home. Some of it marked initiative, some of it in personal caches. Most things you want, someone's got. You just have to figure out who, and what they're willing to take in exchange.
Sounds too easy.
It can't be that simple.
Oh, but it is. Most things are simple once you know the trick to them.
Let's do some flirting. Anyone special in your life?
Have anyone else here with you, besides Sid?
No, just me and Sid. It's always been just the two of us.
No, I mean, someone special.
Special? Oh, you mean like... Oh, no, nothing like that. Who has time? What about you?
Gonna play hard to get. Yeah, no time.
Like you said, who has time?
Eventually things will settle down a bit. Hopefully. Or we'll be dead. Anyway.
How'd you join the initiative?
How did you hear of the Andromeda initiative?
Short answer, Kesh. She was looking for some experimental ship mods, and I knew how to track them down. I thought it was a one-time deal, but she came back. Once, twice. Eventually I figured out something was going on, something big with creds behind it. I asked and she told me about the initiative. New galaxy, new home, couldn't pass that up.
You saw the uprising?
You were on the Nexus when the revolt happened?
When you promise people golden worlds and all they get are wastelands and a death cloud, they riot. Some wanted to go home, some demanded answers, and a couple just wanted to stir shit up.
And you?
Some days I wondered if the exiles had a point. Maybe we were conned into coming here. But why would the initiative go to all this trouble just to screw us over? Thing about conning people, you always know something they don't. And that's why the con works. And if I'm going to pick a side, I'm picking the liars.
I'll let you go.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Okay. And I don't think I did this before, but we can scan Liam's couch. Worn-in couch. Data, style, new modern, transitional. Manufactured by Oglin K. Uvenik. Frame, proprietary alloy steel. Cover, 98% polyester, 2% unknown. It's kind of disturbing. Analysis, while Liam's claims of charge diffusion are dubious, furniture doesn't get this worn without providing comfort. Which, it should be noted, is not the same as being comfortable. Speaking of Liam, let's go talk to him.
Prodromos. Prodromos. Sounds good, doesn't it? We started Pathfinder. A new life. That is goddamn brilliant.
My skill is Pathfinder.
Just wondering what you think of how I'm doing at the job.
I'm committed to the initiative. You're Pathfinder. It's as simple as it gets.
About you.
We barely covered how you joined. Tell me something about yourself.
All right. I was a bad student, piss-poor cop, great responder. Had a good life, but it'd all been done. I wasn't looking to start over. I wanted to start big.
Career history.
You were a cop then, crisis response? Couldn't have been long in either.
Didn't have the patience for law, so I figured enforcement. Dad knew it didn't fit before I did. But it got me into hustle. They mostly take vets and retired service. Best years of my life.
You as a cop seems cliche.
An impatient rookie frustrated by procedure? That's overdone.
I know, right? I wanted new, and I got it. And that led me here.
Family.
Tell me about your family.
I miss the hell out of them. Some nights you just cry, right? That's the thing everyone does. Mom, Joelle, Dad, Calvin. Both lawyers. Met on the Citadel, settled on Earth. No brothers or sisters. That might have been too much to leave. It was traditional. How about you?
Who defines traditional?
Traditional is a weird term for family. Like normal. Who's that describe?
I suppose you're right. I sure didn't keep to tradition. I said goodbye to my mom and dad, and got on a ship to Andromeda.
Goodbye.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
Okay, and I think we're pretty much done here. Let's just take another look really quick. I guess we could go to my cabin and check out my new figurines. But yeah, that's really all there is left to do. Let's go do that. So there you go. My collection is growing. Alright, so we're going to go up to the flight deck. Up to the bridge. And just head right on back to the Nexus.
Where's my data pad? Oh, how'd you get under there?
Suvi, were you talking to your notebook?
Oh, I was, wasn't I? I do that sometimes.
Okay, we're back.
A ray of hope for sleep-starved residents. Maintenance begins.
Okay, we want to go over to the hydroponics. Huh. Someone was talking. Anyways, over here.
Seems quiet for now.
Our leaders.
Look, Jonesy.
I know. This isn't what I signed up for either.
Make them hear. Make them know. Make them lead or make them go. Our nemesis,
hey,
our lives.
You're with the militia, right? What's going on in there?
Make them
a crowd
hear.
Of people in hydroponics, so they won't leave.
Make them lead.
They're disrupting operations. Might get nasty. Can you talk to them?
Sure.
Tell our leaders, wake the sleepers!
Okay, let's talk to this guy.
Make them hear, make them know, make them lead, or make them go!
Hey, what's going on?
That's your new galaxy. Making speeches about some fresh start while your kids stay frozen.
And it's all thanks to your Pathfinder.
Excuse me?
We've waited months for our families to come out of stasis. They should have gone to your outpost.
But since you think research is so important, military personnel got bumped down the list. Like my clan brothers.
All the reassignments mean they're in 10 different colony blocks now.
And my mother just got caught in the middle.
I had to make a choice.
We only had resources for one outpost, so I focused on the skills we needed most.
And what we need is our families back.
Maybe you could still make this right. I just want Mom out of stasis. That's all anyone here wants.
You do stasis revivals. You can tell our leaders you're opening those pods. Today.
This situation's different.
I authorize whole colony blocks or a few emergency revivals. I can't wake dozens of random people.
We don't care whose finger pushes the button. If you can't, our leaders can. And if you tell them, they will.
Let's see, I'll talk to them or my word's not enough. Well, I'll talk to them.
Okay. I'll talk to the leadership about what we can do.
14 months of promises. It's time for some results.
We tried petitioning Addison. She ignored us. Screw her.
Start with Kandros. He sent those 10 soldiers over there. Maybe he'll take us seriously.
All right. We'll go speak with Kandros, who is still in operations. Let's make this my active quest. I don't think it is by default. Okay. And back to operations.
The human pathfinder has died. Alec Ryder was killed after touching down on Habitat 7 in the Erickson system. Ryder's son has reportedly replaced him as Pathfinder, taking command of the Tempest in the ongoing search for a home in Andromeda. This is HNS.
Attention, civil disobedience has been reported in hydroponics.
I'll talk to our
security
informants.
Is investigating.
Glad to see you finally. I hear you've been busy out there.
That's one word for it.
Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Turian Ark.
What's the word on the Turian Ark?
Scattered readings. Some indicate the Natanis was destroyed, others that people are alive. Who knows? If you need anything, come see me, even if it's just a vent.
Stasis protesters.
I need to talk to you about stasis revival and those protesters in hydroponics.
I see. Maybe I should get the others for this.
Protesters have seized hydroponics?
They want their families out of stasis. The outpost on Eos disrupted the schedule. They're scattered across colony blocks, dozens of people. The protesters want this fixed today.
The realities of our position are...
We can't wake those families. We don't have the resources, and there's nowhere to put them.
You're right. Well, we have a whole planet. Well, we don't really have a whole planet. So I guess she's right.
We only just got on our feet. Plus, it messes up the schedule again. What do you suggest?
Leave the families in stasis where it's safe and get those protesters out of hydroponics. They seem sympathetic, but so did the exiles. We can't risk another revolt. Survival is more important than family reunions.
How would you move them?
What would you do with the protesters?
I'd send in a squad and march them out. At gunpoint, if we must. If they resist, a few might land in medbay, but it's better than losing hydroponics. Or the Nexus.
Are the protesters dangerous?
Do you think these protests could turn violent?
We're all pioneers. Even civilians are tough enough to start something.
And interfering in hydroponics threatens our oxygen supply. They know that.
Let's see. You're right. In the protest... Or no, the protesters are right. Well, I wouldn't say they're right, but if we take them down with force, I think that's more likely to lead to a revolt than anything else. So it might be good to let them out of stasis, and plus they're apparently military personnel, and all I've really got is science. So, I don't know if that it's actually going to work out that way, but logically, I think I should go with the protesters on this one. We can make the resources work, and I'm going to probably have another outpost soon, so let's just do that. No, the protesters are right.
These people aren't the enemy. We didn't come all this way to rip families apart. We'll manage the resource squeeze somehow.
Your compassion is admirable, but...
Guess we're all tightening our belts.
You can run a stasis override command from operations. I hope the rest will be that easy.
Alright, hopefully I don't regret this. Authorize stasis revivals from Nexus Operations, which is up here.
Any logistics updates are due within the hour.
No, it isn't what we wanted, but what choice do we...
Okay, sending the override command. The stasis pods should start unlocking.
You're really doing this? I was at the protest in hydroponics. I thought we'd just get more excuses. But we already lost a year waiting for our families. I'm glad it's time.
Resources will be tight.
Things will be lean for a while, with the new mouths to feed.
But you're out there. We'll manage somehow. My mom was scared something would go wrong and she'd be awake in stasis all that time. She isn't... It doesn't work like that, but I just want her out, so I know.
Override complete. Stasis revival triggered on the Nexus. For Jasper K, Griffith G, Pilkvist A, Demerchi P, Kozlov S.
There! That's her!
Go find your mom.
Why are you still here? Go be the face your mom wakes up to.
I will. Thank you.
Given new resource allocation, personnel in stasis on the Hyperion may now be required to wait longer.
When it's time, you'll have a home to wake up to. I promise.
Alright, and I leveled up apparently. We completed that assignment, and my Nexus viability actually went up, which seems a little weird. Alright, and what does that make me? Like level 10 now? Wow, 800 experience for that. That is quite a bit. So what am I? I am level 9, and the Nexus is still level 2. It needs 252 more AVP to get to 3. Alright, so we are done here. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.